Hello and welcome all. I am Professor Ashish Apte, Department of Engineering Sciences at AISSMS IIT Pune. Today we will see involute. In engineering curve, there are two parts. In part one, ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola. And in part two, involute, cycloid, spiral, and helix. Involute again, the part one is involute of a circle which is based on the string length pi d, then is equal to pi d, then string length is greater than pi d and string length is less than pi d. The second pole having composite shapes, and third one is a rod rolling over a semicircular pole. In cycloid, again pi type, that is the general cycloid. Then superior, inferior, epicycloid and hypercycloid. For first year syllabus, general cycloid and epicycloid and hypercycloid included. Then next is a spiral. Spiral is based on the first one is on one convolution, spiral of a one convolution, and since second, spiral of two convolution. Then helix, helix on cylinder, and in second, helix on core. So definitions of the cycloid, involute, and spiral and helix. So first upon cycloid, it is a locus of a point on the periphery of a circle which rolls on a straight line path is called as a cycloid. Involute, it is a locus of a free end of a string when it is wound around a circular pole. The next spiral, it is a curve generated by a point which revolves around a fixed point and at the same moves toward it. Then helix, it is a curve generated by a point which moves around the surface of a right circular cylinder or cone and at the same time advance in axial direction at a speed bearing a constant ratio to the speed of rotation. In cycloid, there are again two types, that is epicycloids, means if the circle is rolling on another circle from outside, then it's called as epicycloid. Hypercycloid means if the circle is rolling from inside the other circle, it's called as hypercycloid. Now we'll see one problem on involute. Draw involute of equilateral triangle having side is 35 mm. So first of all, we have to draw an equilateral triangle and the side is 35 mm. Then draw a line, horizontal line, which is 3 into 35. That is one side, two side and three side. That is 3 into 35. Triangle having a three side, so we have multiplied by here 3 into 35. Then next, extend this side, then these sides, okay. Then next, take a radius of 35 mm in your compass. This is a center point. Draw one arc up to this first line. Take a radius 35 mm in your compass because side of the triangle is given 35 mm. So this is center point, first line, and then start from here up to the first extension line. It intersects here. So this is my first point. Then second, take 2 into 35 in your compass. That is 70 mm is a radius. This is center point and draw the arc up to this second line. This is my second part. Then third, in compass, that is 3 into 35 means 105 mm is radius in compass. This is center point and draw an arc up to the last line here. This is my required involute. We will see another problem on involute. Draw involute of a square of 25 mm side. So this is square, we have to first draw the square of 25 mm side then extend all these points. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. See, this is 100 because the sides of square is 4, so 25 by 4 into 100. Then extend this side one, then second, and then third. Then in compass, take 25 mm as a radius. This is first center point. Draw an arc up to the first line. Then second, in compass, take 25 into 2. That is 50 mm as a radius. This is my center point, and draw arc up to the second line. In case of third, we have to add 25 mm. So 25 into 3. This is my center point, and draw arc up to the third line. This is my third point, okay, here. And then in compass, that is 4. This is 4 point. Take 25 into 4 is 100 mm in your radius in your compass, and draw a line arc up to the last line. So this is required involute. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.